Before we start, I have started a TikTok called TF90 Tips, so be sure to go over there because I will be uploading tips for different games, different leagues, to try and win you lot some money. So definitely go and follow me at TF90 Tips on TikTok. Boys, we are back. Ladies and gentlemen, the full 90 has returned, and I do not want to be taking another break, but a lot went on. Since I had to take a break, we had the Super League come and go, we had the Euros. I definitely missed a trick there not doing the Euros, but I did win a bet on the Euros. Outright Italy to win the entire tournament, which was pretty tasty. And we've had some exciting action from the Premier League and the Champions League already. And I have to say, in terms of predictions, myself and Inter Milan, oh, it's been good. Out of the five games they've played in Serie A, I've predicted three exact scores, the 4-0 and two of the 3-1 results. So Inter Milan, they're kind of like the team that I know. But this is going to be week six Premier League predictions, and we're hopefully just going to go weekly from here. Premier League, Champions League, all that stuff. I want to do my best efforts to keep uploading on this channel because I had a lot of messages, a lot of really kind comments from you lot saying that you missed me, you missed these videos, and that really makes me happy. I'm still a little bit ill, but I will endeavor to give you my predictions and also a tip for each game. Now, obviously, with 10 tips in 10 games, some of them aren't going to come true. Unless I have an absolutely insane week. It's not often I get 10 out of 10 tips. I'm only giving a tip for some of the games because I have to. But I would say really only 4 or 5 tips would be good for an accumulator. And I think I've actually got one for you this week. So please do drop a like, sit back, relax, and we're going to kick it off with a massive game. Chelsea up against Manchester City. Now, Chelsea really look like the real deal. They played really well against Tottenham, particularly in the second half after the change that Thomas Tuchel made, and they got a 3-0 win. Against Aston Villa, they didn't play that great, and they still won 3-0. They still kept a clean sheet. Against Zenit St. Petersburg, they didn't play great, but they still won, and they still got a clean sheet. It's like Chelsea have almost an arrogance about them, as if they know they're going to win. Now, this is going to be a difficult one with Chelsea versus Manchester City. Thomas Tuchel has without a doubt got Pep Guardiola's number. And I think, genuinely, given the fact it's at Stamford Bridge, given the fact that Chelsea are in form, I'm going to go for a Chelsea win here. I genuinely think Chelsea can win this game. So as a score prediction, I'm going to go for a 2-1 win to Chelsea. And it's not often that Chelsea concede. Okay, we're aware of that. Even against Manchester City, it's not often that Chelsea do concede. But Man City, they've got some catching up to do with their result against Spurs and their 0-0 draw against Southampton. But I could easily see this ending 2-0 to Chelsea as well. Or if Man City turn up 2-2, maybe even 3-2 to Manchester City. So my tip is going to be, just because I thought the value was phenomenal, Chelsea to score over 1.5 goals at 2.5. 2 goals, 2.5 odds. I think that's fantastic. I'm going to go for the Chelsea win at 2-1. The next game is Manchester United up against Aston Villa. United and Aston Villa both crashing out of the Carabao Cup. Aston Villa at the hands of Chelsea and Man United at the hands of West Ham. Do I think Man United are going to win this game? Yes, I do. However, Aston Villa looked ridiculously good against Everton. I don't know if you guys saw that game, but I watched it and they looked truly phenomenal. I know they were at home and this time they're going to Old Trafford. It's going to be a little bit different. I think Man United can get this win, but I think both teams will score. And to be honest, I think this is me thinking back to a time when I had a really massive accumulator and the final leg of the accumulator to come in was Manchester United to beat Aston Villa and it ended 2-2. And if Man United did win, I would have won $80,000 and it ended 2-2. I think that was in 2019. You can literally go back and check. I think, just to prove I'm not lying, let me check for you. Yep, just like I thought, December 2019, Man United at home to Aston Villa and it ended 2-2. And I'm not going to be burned by that again. Do I think Man United are going to win like I did back then? Yes, but Aston Villa looked really good against Everton. They looked good against Chelsea, even though they didn't find the back of the net. So I'm going to go for a 3-1 win to Manchester United, but my tip is going to be both teams to score at 1.8. I think there is value in Man United to win and both teams to score, but we'll try and keep it a little bit simpler than that. Next up, we have Everton up against Norwich. Now, Norwich, they lost to a fairly decent Watford performance, it does have to be said, and Norwich haven't looked like really getting a point. The only time they did look like possibly getting something was against a very lackluster Leicester side, and they ended up losing that one 2-1 as well. So given that they're now going to Goodison Park, I don't see Norwich getting anything from this game. They could pop up with a goal here and there, and Everton's resources are somewhat depleted. However, I'm going to go for just a simple 2-0 win to Everton, and my tip, going to keep it simple, Everton to win at 1.6. Now, next up, we have Leeds taking on West Ham. The Hammers will welcome back Antonio to the squad, I assume. assume. I'm pretty sure his sending off was a double yellow, so that means it was only a one game suspension. They will look even better than they did against Manchester United with Antonio up top. And don't get me wrong, I think Man United did deserve the win against West Ham, given the way some of the... I think there was at least one penalty on Ronaldo there that wasn't given, but the ref clearly had it in his head that Ronaldo was diving regardless, and there were fouls on him in the box that weren't given. The West Ham penalty was definitely a penalty, but well saved by David De Gea. I think West Ham are going to look good with Antonio. Leeds definitely should have won against Newcastle, I think. I think it was Dan James taken down in the box. Wasn't even looked at by VAR. Definite penalty for me, and I think Leeds should have won that game 2-1. However, this is another game where I think it's going to be quite high scoring. I think both teams are going to score. I'm going to go for a 2-1 away win to West Ham, but in case it ends 3-3 or something like that, my tip is going to be both teams to score at 1.5. After this, we have Leicester taking on Burnley. Leicester have been looking in a little bit of trouble, spot of bother. Whilst they did lose to Brighton, I think they were unfortunate in doing so. And I think at the King Power Stadium against a Burnley side that haven't been looking great this season are in the relegation zone. I think this is time for Leicester to secure the 3 points. And I'm going to go for another little blip in defence for Leicester. Maybe if Soyuncu plays, he hasn't been playing great in defence this season. So I think Burnley could get a goal here. Perhaps a set piece, a header, something like that. But I'm going to go ultimately for a 2-1 Leicester win. And my tip is going to be Leicester to win at 1.57. Now, after this, we have Watford taking on Newcastle. This is going to be a very difficult one to predict because it depends who turns up. If Ismail Assar turns up, like he did, you know, recently and against Liverpool when they broke their unbeaten streak, Watford could score tons of goals. If Alan Saint-Maximin continues playing the way he's playing, I could see him getting a goal. I'm not sure if Callum Wilson will be returning for this fixture, but you never know with these two teams. So I'm going to err on the side of caution and go for a draw, but high scoring at that. I'm going to go for a 2-2 draw, and my tip is going to be both teams to score at 1.8. I think that's very, very good value. I do not, when I picture Watford and Newcastle, I don't envisage a scoreline where one of them doesn't score. Like, picture this in your head: Watford win 2-0. Just doesn't look right. Newcastle win 2-0. Absolutely not. It just does not look right. So both teams to score there seems like a good shout for me. After that, we have Brentford up against Liverpool. Brentford looking very, very strong against Wolves. Wolves in the past, to quickly touch on them, they've been looking like they've been doing really good performances but not getting the results. However, the Brentford game, Wolves truly were outclassed, and I thought Brentford looked very, very good. And I think at home they are going to have what it takes to score against Liverpool. But Liverpool, of course, have only conceded one goal this season. I believe that was against Chelsea, and they've looked very, very good. So I am tipping Liverpool to concede, but I'm going to go for that 3-1 win to Liverpool in the end. But just in case Liverpool do get a 2-0 win or something like that, I don't see Brentford conceding one or fewer goals. So I think Liverpool could maybe win 2-0 or something if that's the case. So I'm going to go for the 3-1 win to Liverpool, but my tip is going to be Liverpool win and over 1.5 goals at 1.75, just to increase and boost the odds a little bit, because I don't see this ending 1-0. And that is the only outcome that is taken out of the equation when you add over 1.5 goals, of course. Now, next up, these last few games are very, very difficult to predict. So it's a tough one to come back to YouTube for, I must say, but it's Southampton up against Wolves. This could go either way. Initially, I was gonna tip under 2.5 goals, but then the last time they played, Wolves won 2-1, and I could see this randomly ending like 2-2, because Southampton sometimes do have high scoring games. So it was a very difficult one for me. I am still erring on the side of caution. I initially put 0-0. I then thought about 1-0 to Southampton, but I think Wolves are going to come good. So I'm going to go for a 1-0 win to Wolves, but this could end 0-0, and it could end 1-0 to Southampton. Genuinely, this is one of the most difficult ones, but I'm going to go for a 1-0 win to Wolves, and my tip is going to be Wolves double chance at 1.5, given that Southampton are the bookies' favourites at home to take the win. So a game that could very easily end in a draw, I'm going to go for value and go for Wolves double chance at 1.5. Now, next up is the North London derby. After three games, Tottenham on 9 points, Arsenal on 0, and as an Arsenal fan, I genuinely thought Arsenal could be on 9 points after three games. Burnley, Norwich, and Spurs at home, and Tottenham have been struggling, and if they lose this now, it would be 9 points apiece after six games. I want to back Arsenal to win at home. They've been growing into the season a lot more. Tottenham have been falling off since the start of the season, to be honest, and the wins they did get weren't particularly inspiring. They were all with a 1-0 scoreline, a little flash of individual brilliance here and there, but overall not looking great. They looked poor against Chelsea, decent in the first 20 minutes but couldn't take their chances, and against Crystal Palace, I know the red card affected the scoreline, you could argue, but they were never going to win that game. They were well and truly outclassed. So I think I think if I had to pick a winner, I would pick Arsenal at the Emirates, and I would say 2-1. However, it's a North London derby. Things could get spicy, and I think the way this game is going to be slightly more stop-start due to perhaps the tension, I think there's going to be cards here and there. So I'm going to say it's going to be a low-scoring draw, and I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw. I hope Arsenal win, but my tip, this is mad value, draw at 3.3. And obviously, at 3.3, it could be fairly unlikely, so someone could win, but I'm going to go for a draw at 3.3. I hope Arsenal win, but I'm just going to keep it all square. Now, the final game, it doesn't get any easier. It's Crystal Palace up against Brighton. Which Palace are you going to get? Which Brighton are you going to get? Who knows? Now, Brighton have obviously had a fantastic start to the season. They look pretty decent defensively, but they're finally starting to score some of their expected goals that they've been making. You know, the last season that everyone talks about XG, Brighton had a really massive XG but couldn't convert their chances. Now, they're keeping low scoring at their own end, but are converting some of these chances. And Crystal Palace, they're all up and down. They had a brilliant performance against Tottenham at Selhurst Park, and now they're returning back to Selhurst Park. But Brighton, they do play pretty decent football these days, and I could see them nicking a win. This could be a draw, and this could be a Palace win. Genuinely, I would stay away. In terms of a betting point of view, I would stay away from the Southampton Wolves game. I would stay away from the Palace Brighton game, unless you're feeling risky. Obviously, if you're feeling risky and you want to make some money, there is money to be made, for example. But I would stay away from this game, but I'm going to go for a 2-1 win to Brighton. I was really considering a 1-1 draw. I don't see Brighton out and out losing this game, but it's something that could happen. Nevertheless, the score, because I've got to give one, is 2-1 to Brighton, and my tip is Brighton draw no bet at 1.72. If Brighton do get the win as the in-form team, you've got great odds of 1.72, and if they draw, like it very well could be, then you get your money back, you get your stake back, and it's void. So I think that is a good shout. But you never know. And it's going to be an exciting game week for sure. The full 90 is back. Please drop a like for the return, because I'm excited. Thank you once again for the well wishes. I have actually started a TikTok that maybe I will be posting tips on as well. So I should have said this at the start of the video. I'm going to record the intro that you saw just now. So now the intro that you've already seen, I literally just made. But that is going to do it for this video. Drop a like, leave a comment with your predictions as well. And I will see you in the next video very soon.